based on the kind of data and needs of the audience are the key factors in managing successful information systems. So this academy we will be conducting for 10 days, starting from today. So it'll be the entire this week and the next week. So this academy is going to be a kind of a very interactive one and not just a one-way communication based on lectures. So we have so many items arranged for you all. We have lectures, demonstrations, as well as few group activities. And not to forget, there'll be assignments and a final examination as well. So more about this, the structure, agenda, and how the content is organized, we will explain to you later. And I'm sorry for the delay that we had in starting today's session, mainly because we were waiting for a few participants to join who had some issues, some technical difficulties in joining the session. Right, so I assume now we have altogether 45 members. Before we start with the first item, just a kind request. I think some of you have been, if you look at the participants list, we see a lot of you appearing as a DHIS2, the name. So kindly, we kindly request you to rename your name to your own name so that we can identify who's actually using the particular account. This, of course, happened due to some glitches that we had while configuring the our learning management system. So most probably our team is working on that and how to fix it. So in the meantime, I think before we move on to any content and the objectives of this academy, we would like to do a round of introductions. So we have an expert set of panelists, facilitators conducting these sessions. So I think we can introduce the list of facilitators first. So as I mentioned to you before, we have the facilitators representing the HISP India and HISP Sri Lanka, two expert DHIS2 nodes in the Asia region. So let us start start with the HISP India team. Saurabh, if you could introduce your team.
Yeah, thanks, Pramod. Hello, everyone. And we welcome you to the Analytics Level 1 Academy. And thank you for taking the interest in joining the course. We hope that you'll have a fruitful experience over the next 10 days. Introducing myself, I'm Saurabh. I'm working as Lead Health Systems with HISP India. Having around 10 years of experience on DHIS2 implementations, and I'll be one of the facilitators taking the sessions, and we'll be communicating a lot with you through the Slack channels and answering your questions and making sure that the concepts that we cover are well understood, and you moving forward, you'll be able to implement those in your respective work areas. Thank you. Gitika, if you could introduce yourself, please.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gitika, working with HISP India for last 8 years now. I have been working mostly on the tracker implementations, and recently I've been working with the immunization packages and antimicrobial surveillance programs. I'll be taking few sessions in the academy and look forward to talking to all of you. Thank you.
Sumit.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sumit Tripathi. I'm working with HISP India, and it's been almost 6 years working on the DHIS2 implementation. And I will be supporting in this DHIS2 Academy. And welcome to all of you. Thank you so much.
Yogita?
Yeah, Yogita.
Hi, everyone. I'm Yogita. I am working with HISP India from past few years on DHIS2 implementations. and I'll be with you for the next 5 days during this academy, supporting during the sessions. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Okay, all right. So just few lines of introduction on the course, that what are the target audience with for this course and what target areas it covers. So basically, this training will target the people who have been working with DHIS implementations and working with the data where you frequently use the analytical outputs which are available in DHIS too. So through this 10-day course, what we will try to do is to take the analytical apps available in DHIS too on a day-by-day basis and try to cover these apps and the functionalities and the various features they have in terms of producing outputs for the data which the programs and the implementations are capturing. The focus is more on the analytical components of what is feasible to do in DHIS2. It may not be focusing extensively on how to convert data to action or how to actually focus more on the data use component, but it would be more on the functionality aspects of DHIS2 in terms of how we can help you build your capacities to use DHIS analytical apps to produce the analytical objects and items, which could be further utilized for taking decisions and converting data into action. We will be having brief sessions on the data to action framework, where we will be talking about how DHIS2 can be used as a tool to convert data into action. But then largely the focus of the academy would be towards using the analytical tools in DHIS2 and how to go about it. And you'll have various theory sessions, you'll have practical hands-on exercises, you'll have both ungraded and graded assignments, which will kind of help you to do practical, get a practical understanding of the topics and use DHIS2 more actively in your implementations. The learning goals that we have is to, since we all belong to the DHIS2 community, because we're the users of the global code that is being developed over so many years. So we would like the participants to get an increase in the level of understanding of the features, and so that you're able to produce the reporting outputs using the DHIS2 analytic applications. How you could use the core analytic applications within DHIS2 to produce reports and increase the ability to use supplementary applications, which might not be part of the DHIS2 core software, but then can help you to review data and produce reports within the DHIS2 system. So the performance objectives that we have for this course is to how we could use the analytical tools within DHIS to review the quality of data. So since we are kind of working in implementations where data is of high importance, and if the quality of data is not good, then it kind of doesn't help us to reach our objectives that we had in terms of using a tool for data management. So we will have some dedicated sessions where you could use how you could utilize the analytical features in DHIS2 to manage the quality of data. Then we will focus upon the explanations behind the analytical apps and how to basically construct different analytical outputs, what considerations you can take in terms of designing your outputs, and what are the do's and don'ts and the best practices towards doing that. Then it's important that we share the data and make it open for interpretations and kind of present that data to a wider audience so that we're able to get more feedback on the data that we're collecting, and kind of helps us to kind of build a communication around data and how that communication can support the teams and the program managers, the M&E officers, to take better decisions on the data that they're trying to collect. And then provide participants with the real experience of using data within DHIS2. So we'll have take a couple of examples where we have kind of designed the programmatic data in a way that could kind of resemble a real scenario within the system for different health programs. So we'll have a look at those use cases and do those exercises to kind of understand if you were working for, say, HIV, malaria, or the tuberculosis program, then how you can use DHIS2 as your analytical system to kind of monitor the quality of data and take decisions based on the data which you kind of present to others through the analytical apps available in the system. Then we'll be also focusing upon the design choices in terms of, as I mentioned, that when you are designing outputs, there are multiple ways in which you can present the data, but then there might be better options available where the same data could be represented in different forms, and there are some preferred forms which kind of adds more value to the data which is getting collected. So we'll focus upon what design choices, what implementation considerations you can make when you think of designing outputs from the DHIS to analytical applications. And then we'll also have a look at the certain components which could be configured to kind of support the analysis of data within DHIS2. And then based on the experience that we've had in working with different countries with different health programs, what challenges that we've seen in terms of analytical outputs, and what could be the potential solutions to address those outputs. Because one size doesn't fit all. If DHIS2 can do something which another system might do better, but then we of course cannot implement all the systems at one place. So if we have better examples of analytical solutions available, then how we could manage the same things within DHIS2 and what are the alternate solutions available so that we find the right balance between what the system can do for you and what are your requirements in terms of the analytical needs which you have for your respective health program. So this would be kind of a mix of building core components within DHIS2 and utilizing the applications for compiling information together, what is already available in the system. So there are certain DHIS2 items which are all core functionalities. We'll be focusing on these functionalities on a day-by-day basis and try to see that how these particular apps add more value to the analysis which you want to carry out. So validation rules are kind of the logics which kind of add the data quality layer on top of your data. So we'll see that how validation rules can kind of help you to identify basic quality issues with the data. If things are not related to each other and still if they have been reported in a higher number or lower number, then if we have these predefined logics which can run over your data set and can give you errors, that these are the potential conflicts with the data, which can help you kind of see relationship between two variables, or you can set thresholds and you can see the consistency of data over a period of time. So validation rules have multiple use cases where they could be reflected upon. So we'll see these use cases and kind of guide you through the process of how you can create such validation rules for different functions within the DHIS2 system. Then we'll focus more on the analytical applications which are already available in DHIS2. The pivot tables, the charts, and the maps. So these are three core applications which are available in the system, which kind of help you to create analytical objects, which could be in a tabular format if you talk about pivot tables, which can be different kind of charts. Multiple chart types are supported within DHIS2. We'll see what chart types fit what kind of data, some orientation on that, and then spatial analysis of data through maps. So maps are a good platform, a good mechanism to see the overall spread of data over geography, and you could see it over time and move across the hierarchy depending upon how the maps have been configured in your DHIS2 implementation. So we'll have a look at that. And then we'll move to the more core areas of data presentation, visualization, and sharing and dissemination of data. So through the interpretations and the dashboard components, we'll have a look at how we can create these objects, assemble them into a well laid out story, a dashboard, and how that dashboard can become a tool to kind of build a communication around data through use of interpretations. So these would be the core focus areas and the learning objectives of this academy for the next 10 days. So we will be kind of putting a lot of emphasis on providing you with as much hands-on exercises as possible So when we review the agenda, we'll see that there are multiple exercises after each subsection of the topic of the day that we cover. And there are some things that we need to note, that the focus largely would be on to kind of enable you to kind of enhance your capabilities in terms of creation of the outputs. Configuration of things might not be covered in detail because that is part of the other academies that we run for DHS to configuration. So we'll not be focusing more on the configuration. We'll be focusing more on the pre-configured items which are already there, the data elements, the indicators, the validation rules, and we'll see how we can kind of take these things together and build more analytical objects out of it. So the course will have a set of quizzes and assignments that will contribute to your final grade. And the overall grade should be 70 and above in order for you to get a certificate from the EDX system. So all the courses will, all the graded assignments will get automatically graded based on the response which you provide on your OpenEdX account. And based on the calculation of scores, at the end of the course, if you have been able to attend all the sessions and have been able to do all the assignments correctly, then automatically a score will get generated and your option of generating the certificate would get enabled through the score. So this is the learning and evaluation plan based on the different assignments that we will give you and the weightages that each of them carry. Attendance is critical, so we request you to please ensure that you maintain the continuity and do register your attendance daily on the OpenEdX platform. That holds a weight of around 10% to the overall score. Then you'll have graded assignments for pivot tables, data visualizer, maps, and dashboards. So these would be, these exercises would be available on edX. You need to just input your answers there, and these graded exercises would be done after the day for that specific topic is over, and you'll have some grace period to submit your assignments for each of the topics which have a graded component associated to it. Then you'll have on day 9 you'll have the full day to do a comprehensive exercise, which would be a sort of a case study which kind of will bind all the concepts, all the topics that you've covered across the 8 days, and that would be also an automatic submission on the OpenEdX portal, and you will be graded accordingly based on the responses which provide to the questions. And then there will be a final exam, which would be where you'll have an hour, 15 minutes to answer 40 multiple choice questions, and based on your responses, you'll be graded for that specific exam. So these are the components which are essential for you to submit your responses against, so that the LMS is able to process your final scores and it can generate a certificate. And hopefully, we hope that you all will be able to attend all the sessions and submit all the assignments, and also give the exam on day 10, so that the certificates and all could be generated for you with the flying colors. So just a quick overview of the course. Today we're on day 0. So we'll be basically covering just the scheme of things. We are already on the course overview, and Grant has already given you an introduction of the learning platform. We'll be quickly doing an introduction of the Slack platform, which you can use for all the communication which you want to do with the facilitators for different aspects. So we'll go through that after the session. And we'll have a couple of demonstrations today to kind of give an overview of the analytics tool features which are available in DHIS2. Day 1 and day 2, as I mentioned, we'll be focusing on the validation rule aspects, which kind of are the data quality component within the DHIS2 construct. So we'll introduce the validation rules and then kind of configuring simple rules, then how you could use thresholds in validation rules, how you can create validation rule notifications where a user group could be notified of potential data quality issues with the data, and then how you can use validation rules to check the internal consistency of data, and how you can use validation rules against calculated thresholds. So the next 2 days, day one and day two, tomorrow and day after, we'll focus on the data quality aspects. Day three, we'll be covering pivot tables, and we will be taking you through different options available in the pivot tables app. What are the options available to create your tables, select your dimensions, and choosing different layouts, using disaggregations, downloading data, using legends and all that. So all the features which are essential to create good tables in which could kind of summarize your data in a presentable format, we'll be covering those respective topics. Day four, we'll focus on Data Visualizer, which is basically the charting application. So we'll see what are the different chart types available, how you can work with the layouts with different chart items, the chart types available, the use of disaggregation, and what are the new components which have been introduced in the latest releases of DHIS2. So we'll cover that in the Data Visualizer session. Then we'll talk about maps to give you an overview of the thematic layers and the all the layers available, basically the boundary layer, facet layers, and how you can work with the legends, how you can move across the hierarchy with the data by drilling the map. And new features have been added recently for split and timeline maps, so we'll have a look at that as well. Day seven, we'll focus on the dashboards and the reports app in terms of how you can create dashboards, how you can share dashboards, how you can use the dashboards for sharing your kind of set of analytical objects which you've combined together. And then there is a separate reports app which kind of helps you to look at the reporting rate summaries of the data, the data set reports, and the distribution of org units within your administrative hierarchy which you have built in the system. Day eight, we'll be focusing on the interpretations in terms of how to use the data to action framework in DHIS2 through the analytical objects which you have created till date in your exercises, and in terms of considerations which you can use in your existing implementations. So how best you could use the analytical outputs in your implementation, and what are the challenges that we have foreseen globally in terms of the analytical capabilities in DHIS2, and what are the other solutions available which could be put into place for making the best benefit out of the system. Day 9 and 10, we have the comprehensive exercise, and day 10 would be the last day of the course, which would be the exam. And hopefully by the end of day 10, you all will be able to pass the exam with good results. So this was kind of an overview of the entire course, what we intend to achieve through these next 10 days, what are different topics that we'll cover, just an overview of the various sessions which will be there in each day. So if there are any questions, then I can take those up. If not, then we can have a small break before we proceed to the next set of sessions.